am Lily Tunjaren. I teach English as a second language at St. Petersburg College. I'm on the Clearwater campus usually, but sometimes travel to other campuses, such as today. I'm in Seminole.
Welcome to the program, Lily.
Thank you.
What does lifelong learning mean?
To me, lifelong learning is exactly what it says. So we continue as people to learn throughout our lives. Lifelong learning means not ever being finished. I may have a degree in a certain area. I went to college and I finished college, but I wouldn't say I have finished learning. So for me as a teacher, for example, I'm very interested in how people learn, and I want to always try to better the ways that I teach. So I take workshops, I look for things where I can go out and help myself to become a better teacher. But I'm also interested in other things, such as gardening or just reading and how to run my household better with finances. So I'm always learning to be a more, I would say, an effective person in the society, more efficient with my time. And there's so many things available to all of us. Pinellas County has a lot to offer.
What are some examples of lifelong learning activities?
Well, as I said, most people consider lifelong learning an area of interest. So there can also be a need. An example would be something like, I'm going to take my driver's license test, but I don't know how to drive. So there are manuals available online. People can go to the libraries and study before the test. These kinds of things are need-based. What I mean is based upon I need to learn a specific thing in order to do something else. That's one type of lifelong learning. A lot of libraries are great places to get information on things like that, as well as colleges, high schools, middle schools. Most schools and libraries have this type of information. Some churches also, or synagogues, if you're involved in a religious community. But another type of lifelong learning is what various organizations, governments, schools offer to the community. I have a couple examples with me that I was just reading. For example, this one here is from the college, from St. Petersburg College, where it says learn to earn. And these courses are offered not as much for students who are in a long-term 2-year or 4-year degree, but are based more on availability of time, such as just one night a week for 6 weeks, or for on Saturdays for 1 month. And there are even some that are just one meeting for 3 hours. And some of these are computer kinds of classes, so to learn how to use email better, how to save files, how to run a financial spreadsheet, and things like that. So those are all skills that can be used in life at home, but also to help on a resume to get a job and to be able to say, I have these skills. That's really the basis for this Learn to Earn program. But I was also just looking through the newspaper. This paper comes free to my house. I live in Clearwater, so it's the Clearwater Beacon. Some people may see Seminole Beacon or Largo, but these are free newspapers that are usually sent once a week. You can find them on the side of the road, in my case, in my driveway. And I noticed here that starting next week, there is something called People's Law School. And for 8 weeks on Thursday evenings at the college in Clearwater, I can go in for free and learn each week about something different. For example, one of them is constitutional law. So for an hour and a half, I can sit and learn in a college classroom with other people from the community that are interested. Another one is writing a will. How do we write a will for our children? Real estate property. So things like this. Experts from the community are willing to teach others about what they know and what they think that we as citizens or even visitors should know. So these kinds of things are what I look for as a lifelong learner, because I'm never satisfied that I know enough and I'm interested in many things. So generally speaking, because I work at a college, I start with that. I have a lot of information at the college, and almost every week I'll see something. Oh, I would like to go learn about that. I would like to go learn about this. Also, as a professional, I feel that I should give to others too. So when I can help, I like to offer extra classes. I have worked at libraries, tutoring, or helping people learn to be tutors. So I think lifelong learning also involves giving of ourselves as we learn from what's around us to be able to offer to help others as well.
Where else, besides a college, can a person find lifelong learning activities?
So I think libraries would be my number one spot. But also, churches offer sometimes free classes if you would like to drop by again and look at the bulletin board. You can look online. If you have a computer or you go to a library and use a computer and use Google or something and put in what you are looking for. There is also the Pinellas County government website and the Pinellas County School Board website. By looking through those websites, you can find lots and lots of activities that may be taking place outdoors, even at parks and things, such as Largo Central Park. They recently had an health information day where people could come and visit different tables to learn more about being a healthy person. So it's pretty much endless, I would say, where you can find places to learn.
Well, that's all the time we have for today, Lily. Thanks for the good information.
Thank you, and good luck with your English language learning and living in Pinellas County.